Scott, under city ordinance, it's illegal for homeowners to rent out their homes for less than 30 days, 60 days if you live in the French Quarter. Some neighborhood groups say it's happening more and more, and it's taking away from the character of their neighborhoods.
No controls, there's no registration, the identities of the guests are never shown. This has been broken two times, so.
Lisa Romanenko was fed up with the constant stream of short-term renters at her Marini home.
We had trees here, and if that's not enough, this entire yard is full of RVs and tents. And so bad that he cut all the trees down to make room for him.
She rents one side and says the landlord has turned the other side into an unauthorized bed and breakfast.
But all the guests that come have privileges to use my washer and dryer, and they go and they access the key right there.
The landlord has been warned by the city, but Romanenko says the tenants keep coming, and now she's being forced out. Neighbors say this is one of several illegal short-term rentals on their block.
Sometimes I'll see as many as 20 or 25 people at one building, in one building. We did not move here to be in a commercial area.
Some neighbors tell us that rooms are turned over so often it's hard to keep track of who's coming and going, and that presents a safety concern for their neighborhood. The problem in some neighborhoods has gotten so bad signs like this one have been popping up, especially ahead of Jazz Fest that draws thousands of tourists to town.
The problem of illegal short-term rentals in New Orleans is huge, and it's getting bigger every single day. There are whole blocks in the French Quarter where there used to be 20 or 30 households that are now, there are now two or three households because all the other places are being rented out illegally for short-term purposes.
Many of the rentals are listed on the internet on sites like Craigslist or Airbnb, and it's happening all over the city. In Treme, neighbors on this block of Ursuline have had at least two community meetings about the problem.
I think where people buy a house or have a rent out an entire house where they have 15 or 16 people come and stay, that's a big problem for the neighborhood.
Some of the short-term rental units go for hundreds of dollars a night and have three-night minimums for big events.
It's so lucrative, and it gets excessive. And when anything gets excessive, I think that's when you have problems.
Now, we talked to one of the property owners who didn't want to be identified, but tells us in part, quote, that there should be a reasonable solution to the short-term rental issue that preserves the integrity of the residential neighborhood while also providing needed tax revenue to the city. We'll see what happens. Scott.
All right, Gina, thanks. A spokesperson for the city says, quote, they look into properties that have received complaints and send violation notices when applicable. In some cases, those in violation can be fined up to $575.